Well, here in this country, especially in election season, we've become used to politicians saying all sorts of things, offensive things, ugly things, cuss words, abuses, profanities. But a BJP MP from Akola, Sanjay Dhotre, has kicked up a major controversy and sparked outrage. None of this has lost any of its ability to shock people anymore. He said, let farmers die. If they're dying, let them die. The outrageous comment, even more shocking, as it comes from a politician who himself represents the Akola constituency, which is in Vidarbha, one of the most notorious areas in the country as far as farmer debt and suicides is concerned. It has seen 12 farmer deaths in just the last 72 hours, all from the burden of financial loans and poverty. Well, if you haven't quite stomached what this man said, let's listen in to the Honorable MP Sanjay Dhotre. Here's what he has to say about farmers who find no way but to kill themselves.
आता आपली जी स्थिती असेल तर शेतकरी काय करतो आणि शेतकऱ्याला तर काहीच पाहिजे नाही. मला तर कधी कधी असं वाटते की आपले जे धोरण असतात त्यामुळे शेतकरी संकटात येऊन राहतो. मी तर कितीदा चिडून हे म्हटलेलं आहे की शेतकऱ्याकडे काही लक्ष न देता मरू द्या त्याला. ज्याला पटलं तो शेती करेल, करणार नाही जे होईल ते होईल.
I want to get in a word because the anger from this, these comments from this man, this member of parliament, range far and wide. Sachin Sawant of the Maharashtra Congress is with us on the phone line for a comment. Mr. Sawant, this is a man who represents a constituency in Vidarbha and he says, let farmers die.
Well, this is very unfortunate. I believe that it can be called as very bad. And it indicates the kind of mindset this BJP government and their leaders are having. And this is not going to be, this is not the first time this is happening. Even the revenue minister had gone to the extent of giving a statement that farmers can pay mobile bills but they don't have money to pay electricity bills.
Hmm.
And even we had termed him as a modern Nero because he chose to go for a movie and left the ailing farmers, in his tour, and never.
But what kind of punishment? Punishment does this man deserve, sir? What kind of punishment does this man deserve? Can it simply be ignored, or should something be done?
Definitely. He is a member of parliament, and these are not welcome remarks from the representative of the people. And since he is from Vidarbha, it is very unfortunate because the farmer suicides are at peak in Vidarbha and even in many other parts of Maharashtra. Modi in his campaign had actually raised this particular issue and we were expecting that he would come up with the kind of expectations.
This is just
had,
incredible. It's not just apathy, it's incredible. It's a lack of sensitivity, it's cruelty and a complete disregard for the underprivileged in this country. The farmers, for an agricultural nation and an agricultural economy like India, where suicides happen among the farmer community, especially in Vidarbha, this man stands there on a political stage and say, if they're protesting, let them protest. If they're dying, let them die. Let's simply ignore them. He didn't mean it in jest. He meant it. And he have it on audio as well. That's the main part. He says he's been quoted out of context. Kamlesh Sutar, my colleague, joins me live on this story. He brought us this video a short while ago. Kamlesh, has there been any reaction within the BJP in Maharashtra about what's happening? This man is a member of parliament, but has there been any call at all, for some kind of action to be taken against Sanjay Dhotre?
Well, no reaction officially that has come in from the BJP, at least on camera. When we tried speaking to some of the leaders, so off camera, they said that the statements are being quoted out of context, and that's a very classic reply. In fact, every time when any political leader
digs into
any controversy like this, the reply is a classic from all the political party defending him, saying that the statements are made out of context. Whatever Sanjay Dhotre wanted to say, whatever he was intending to say, the kind of word, the choice of words and the tone and tenor which he used in the entire speech while referring to farmer suicides was certainly not in good taste. At least being a MP, being a member of parliament from the ground zero of the agrarian crisis, the ground zero of farmer suicide in Maharashtra, Vidarbha region, Sanjay Dhotre himself has been talking about farmer suicides in that region. Somebody like him using that kind of language of farmers, let them die if they want to do what he says. He goes on to say that those who can afford farming can continue to do, those who cannot should stop it. This is a very casual remark about farmer suicide, about a very serious issue that has caught the attention of the nation for last few years. Farmers have continuously been committing suicides, ending their life, and in last 72 hours, 12 farmers have committed suicide. Something coming on the backdrop of this is certainly not a casual remark. It's certainly very insensitive, at least from a member of parliament.
Kamlesh, has there been any political heat generated at all by this statement, or is the opposition happy just to twiddle its thumbs in Mumbai and elsewhere?
Well, certainly this has given a ready issue on the platter to the opposition in Maharashtra, particularly the NCP. NCP says that this goes on to show the double standards of BJP, which has used the issue of farmer suicides in Maharashtra. In fact, Narendra Modi, who had addressed several rallies in Maharashtra during the Lok Sabha as well as the assembly elections this year, he had used this issue of farmer suicides. In fact, Mar Jawan Mar Kisan was one of the slogans which Modi had used in Maharashtra to show the seriousness of the issue of farmer suicides and how casually Maharashtra government, the then Maharashtra government of Congress and NCP, has been tackling the issue. But now the NCP is turning the tables on the BJP and saying that this is the double standard of BJP. On one hand, they have used this issue of farmer suicides to come to power, and when they have come to power, they are using this kind of language against farmers, going on to an extent to say that if farmers are committing suicide, let them do so, let them die.
Thanks, Kamlesh, for getting us the latest on this. We're going to try and get more reactions from the BJP at the center as well, to see if this man, Sanjay Dhotre, or whatever his name is, who was in a member of parliament from Akola in Maharashtra, deserves to remain a member of parliament. Does he deserve to remain in the BJP? We will find out what the central leadership thinks. Thanks, Kamlesh, for that. And here's what Nawab Malik of the NCP, not a party known for saying the best of things about the underprivileged in Maharashtra, but anyway, here's what Nawab Malik says.
The statement of Mr. Dhotre shows the double standard of Bharatiya Janata Party. Earlier, Mr. Modi was taking the issue of suicidal of all the farmers in the country. Now the BJP MP said, let them die. Don't do anything for them. This kind of a mindset is there of Bharatiya Janata Party.
And just in case you didn't hear what BJP MP Sanjay Dhotre said about farmers, let's just play out that soundbite for you.
आता आपली जी स्थिती असेल तर शेतकरी काय करतो? आणि शेतकऱ्याला तर काहीच पाहिजे नाही. मला तर कधीकधी असं वाटतं की आपले जे धोरण असतात त्यामुळे शेतकरी संकटात येऊन राहतो. मी तर कितीदा चिडून हे म्हटलेलं आहे की शेतकऱ्याकडे काही लक्ष नका, तुम्ही मरू द्या त्याला. त्याला पटलं तो शेती करेल, करणार नाही जे होईल ते होऊ द्या.
With New Year just around the corner, Church Street in Bengaluru is usually buzzing with people. The street is famous for its high-end restaurants, but the scene, as you can imagine, is very different today. The street is crowded, but with police and National Investigation Agency teams. On Sunday evening, a low-intensity blast rocked the city. The Home Ministry says it's a terror attack. The police are trying to probe every angle. One woman lost her life, but the big question is this only a warning? Are more such terror attacks simply waiting to happen?
A low-intensity blast rocked Bengaluru on a busy Sunday evening, killing one and injuring five. The Home Ministry termed it as a terror attack.
Are you calling it a terror attack?
Definitely. It's a terror attack. Yeah.
While high-level meetings were held in Bengaluru and in New Delhi, Home Minister Rajnath Singh said that an intelligence alert had been given to the state. Karnataka Chief Minister Siddaramaiah said that despite all preventive measures, a blast took place in the metro city.
नहीं अलर्ट तो किया ही गया है, अलर्ट तो पहले भी जारी किया गया
है. Yes, that is why we have taken all measures, whatever precautionary measures are needed, we have taken. Despite the measures we have taken, this has happened.
Meanwhile, all angles of investigation are being explored. Two teams of the NIA are probing the case. A timer was used to trigger the blast at 8:30 p.m. on Sunday. The bomb was placed an hour before it went off. It went unnoticed as it's a busy area this time of the year. Reports say police are unhappy with the quality of the CCTV footage, crucial for the investigations.
We were just standing there, a few of us talking, and we noticed this loud noise. And suddenly we saw a lady collapsing on the ground. Uh-huh. And we could make out it's a bomb blast.
In the last 20 days, two alerts had been issued for Bengaluru about a possible terror strike. The first one was a specific alert following the arrest of pro-ISIS Twitter handler Mehdi Masroor Biswas. Not ruling out any possibility, the police are probing the Simi activist who escaped in the Khandwa jailbreak last year. It is believed that the modus operandi adopted bears similarity to previous attacks carried out by Simi activists. Reports also suggest that there are striking similarities between Bengaluru and the earlier Chennai train blast.
There are similarities between different incidents across the country. We are in touch with the national agencies. In coordination with them, we are working.
The Bangalore police is leaving no stone unturned when it comes to the investigation to the blast that took place on Church Street. The police are playing their cards very close to the chest, not revealing which organization could be behind these blasts. But the question is, if there was an intelligence report that said that Bangalore was a soft target and there could have been a terror attack in the city, then why was the Bangalore police not alert enough? The question is, was the Bangalore police caught napping? With Pratibha Raman Roni Swami in Bangalore for Headlines Today.
Well, he's the man who directed the 2611 attacks in Mumbai from a control room in Karachi. The man who promised Ajmal Amir Kasab 1,50,000 rupees to execute that plan. And he now is all set to walk free from a jail in Pakistan. The Islamabad Anti-Terror Court today, or such as it is, cancelled the detention notification of Lashkar-e-Taiba commander Zakir Rehman Lakhvi. Just a few days ago, Nawaz Sharif had promised to crack down on terror following the massacre in Peshawar. Is setting Lakhvi free part of Pakistan's war on terror?
2611 mastermind Zakir Rehman Lakhvi is all set to walk out of jail in Pakistan after Islamabad High Court cancelled his detention notification. This just weeks after Pakistan Prime Minister Nawaz Sharif promised to crack down on terror on its soil. Pakistan's deceit prompted the Ministry of External Affairs to summon the High Commissioner and express concern at the lack of effective action by Pakistan's prosecuting authorities.
Here at South Block in the Ministry of External Affairs, Pakistan's High Commissioner to India, Abdul Basit, was summoned on Monday afternoon. He was here for almost 15 to 20 minutes. Indian Foreign Secretary Sujata Singh there lodging a very strong protest on the issue of Islamabad High Court, of course, allowing Lakhvi to, in a way, walk scot-free.
Legal loopholes is what led to the 2611 mastermind walking free. Islamabad Anti-Terror Court's order said that weak evidence and irrelevant sections invoked in the FIR ultimately helped Lakhvi. What's even more shocking is that Pakistan government's lawyer was not even present in court to oppose the cancellation of Lakhvi's detention notification. Lakhvi was arrested in February 2009 after the lone surviving 2611 attacker, Ajmal Kasab, identified him as one of the masterminds of the carnage. David Coleman Headley, convicted in the United States for planning the attacks, had also identified Zakir Rehman Lakhvi as the operations mastermind for the attack on Mumbai, in which 166 people were killed. The question is, how much more evidence does Pakistan need? With Smita Sharma in Delhi, Bureau Report, Headlines Today.
And there's breaking news coming in. Top Maharashtra politicians will soon have to shed their security cover. The Devendra Fadnavis-led BJP government has decided to drastically cut the heavy security cover provided to leading politicians and their family members. Those who will be affected by the new decision include Ashok Chavan, former Chief Minister, Narayan Rane, former Chief Minister, Prithviraj Chavan, former Chief Minister, Ajit Pawar, former Deputy Chief Minister, Chagan Bhujbal, former Deputy Chief Minister, R.R. Patil, former Deputy Chief Minister.